Hello student, welcome to the lecture. In this lecture, we are going to discuss the application of coordination compound. So we know that the coordination compounds are very much important in various fields. There are thousands of coordination compounds are synthesized and applied. So in this section, we are going to discuss some important applications of coordination compound in various fields. Industrial applications. We know that the gold and silvers are very expensive metals. It is very difficult to separate it because in nature it will be formed in very small excess in combined state, and it have also a wide applications in various fields. So in industrial application we will discuss the extraction of gold and silver. We know that the gold and silvers are very wide applications in various fields. It have a very expensive metal. When the metals are formed in combined state in nature, it is very difficult to separate this metal from that respective ore. So if you detect the aqueous solution of cyanide with respective ore, then it is very easy to extract this metal from the respective ores. Now in this typical process, what we have to do, treat the crushed ore with the aqueous solution of cyanide solution, then in presence of air, then what happen, these metals form complexes with this cyanide and we can easily remove or we can easily extract the these metals from their respective ores. Now what happen actually, if suppose we have to crush ore that is in solid form when it treated with the aqueous solution of cyanide ion in presence of air, the respective gold complexes will form with the cyanide as an ion. So from that we can easily separate the gold from their respective ore. Now the next application, that is the extraction of nickel. Now we know that the nickel is purified by Mohn process. So if nickel can treated with the carbonyl as an ligand, then nickel carbonyl complex will be formed. And this nickel carbonyl complex is further heated, then it will be easily formed, or we can easily separate the nickel from that respective complex. Now let's discuss the reaction. The reaction, suppose we taken as nickel is in solid state, and if we pass the carbon monoxide gas in that nickel, then there is a formation of nickel complex which is in solid state. Again, if this nickel is again further heated, then there is a separation of nickel metal and the again carbon monoxide gas is releases. So then by this simple method we can extract the nickel. Even nickel is treated with the carbon monoxide gas, it will be formed the nickel tetracarbonyl gas, which is a very highly toxic, and so that's why we are again heating this nickel tetracarbonyl. Then it will be separated nickel and carbon monoxide as a gas. So these are the simple extraction method of nickel. Now the next application, that is industrial application, that is in polymerization. We know that in polymerization there is one of the famous catalyst, that is Ziegler-Natta catalyst is used. So Ziegler-Natta catalyst catalyst is used in polymerization polymerization of ethene. Polymerization of ethene to form polyethylene. So these are the one of the most important industrial application of coordination compound, and the Ziegler-Natta catalyst form coordination compound with the respective ethene and form or the polymerized ethene to polyethene. Now the next second, there is a hydrogenation reaction. We know that in hydrogenation the Wilkinson catalyst, that is RH rhodium complex CLPPH3. Wilkinson catalyst can hydrogenated. It is a very effective and selective at room temperature and ordinary pressure. If we use this catalyst for the hydrogenation of double bond, it can selectively hydrogenate the end chain double bond. It can hydrogenate the alkene groups at the end of chain elsewhere, the double bond in the chain. So these are the important applications, and this selectivity is very important in pharmaceutical use of Wilkinson catalyst. Is also used in oxo process. So we can write here also Wilkinson catalyst also used in oxo process, which is very important for the production of aldehyde. After aldehyde is converted into alcohol, so it is a very important process. Again, the next application, that is in medical use, in medical applications. Now recently some of the platinum complexes are very effective to inhibit the growth of cancerous cells. So we know that the famous one, that is a cisplatin, is an anti-cancer drug. So there are likewise cisplatin, there are various metal complexes of platinums are used in a treatment of cancerous cells. So cisplatin is effective rather than trans, because transposition is ineffective in the treatment with the cancerous cells. So here the cisplatin platinum complexes or the complexes inhibit the growth of cancerous cell. Cancerous cell. So the example, that is, we know that cisplatin transform. The transplatin means the transform of platinum complexes is ineffective towards the cancerous cells because it cannot bind properly with that respect to DNA and RNA. So the structure of that cisplatin, we know that, that is this NH3. Again, likewise, there are various platinum complexes here which effectively in transposition cis position. So here there are various platinum complexes which shows various effective medical applications. So these are the various platinum complexes which are majorly or effectively in cis position only, and they form very wide applications in medical field. Chelating agent editing. On the second number, the chelating agent EDTA is used in lead poisoning. So this is one of the important application of EDTA complexes. Soaps and detergents are form a insoluble curdy white PPT in hard water. Due to in hard water, we know that the calcium ions are present. So later on, the detergent industry introduced a builder, that is sodium tripolyphosphate. This sodium tripolyphosphate form a complexes with these hard ions, means the calcium ions, and form the soluble calcium tripolyphosphate complex ion. And this calcium tripolyphosphate is soluble and it increases the washing and cleaning action of the detergent. The calcium tripolyphosphate ion, which is a soluble and stable in hard water also. So due to this stable formation of the complexes, the detergents are easily, this complexes or this PPT is easily soluble, and it increases the washing action or the washing power of the detergents and soap respectively. In analytical applications, the coordination compounds play a very important role in complexometry. So first, in analytical, that is a complexometry applications, we know that EDTA is a chelating agent. It can form complexes with at least 40 metal ions. If we use the proper pH and indicator, then it is very easy to extract or estimate the metal from their respective solution. So EDTA here can use as a complexing agent. Complexing agent with many metal ions usually which is used in extraction of metals. We know that in gravimetry, it's a black zine, that is DMG, then this dimethyl glycine forms a complexes with, or the insoluble PPTB forms insoluble PPT with nickel ion and platinum ion. So we can easily separate or estimate, or gravimetrically we can separate these two metals or estimate these two metals. Now likewise, 8-hydroxyquinoline is also have a same application, as it can use for the gravimetrically separation of some metal ions. So 8-hydroxyquinoline forms complexes, so it can also use as a 8-hydroxyquinoline is used in separation, in gravimetrically separation of some metal ions. These are the applications of coordination compound in complex symmetry and in gravimetry also. Now let's discuss the applications of coordination compound in living systems like industrial, medical and domestic household applications. Coordination compounds play a very important role in living system also. Coordination compound play a very important role in many biological processes also. We know that the hemoglobin and myoglobin, also vitamin B12, is also a organometallic or the coordination compound. Hemoglobin can transport the oxygen in our body. Also, chlorophyll is a coordination compound. It helps in the photosynthesis, a very important process, that is a photosynthesis. Now, biological processes. In living system, it can transport and store oxygen as an transporting agent like hemoglobin and storing agent, that is myoglobin. We know that hemoglobin transport the oxygen from lungs to tissue in our body, and likewise also myoglobin is also store oxygen, and whenever required they can release the oxygen and it will be transported by the hemoglobin. Now chlorophyll also a coordination compound, in that it will play a very important and vital functions in photosynthesis also. Now we can say that in living systems it will play a very important role in transport and storage of oxygen, that is carried by hemoglobin and myoglobin. Now it also play important role in photosynthesis also. In photosynthesis we know that in chlorophyll there is a magnesium ion is present, and magnesium form a very important role or play a very important role in photosynthesis processes. So in photosynthesis, a very important role and in chlorophyll we know that the magnesium ion is present and it is one of the coordination compound. So in photosynthesis, the chlorophyll or the metal ions play a very important role. Now in biological system also, as like our requirement, we need essential metals for in large quantities, because essential metals play a very vital role in our normal body functioning. Likewise in plant also, there are many various metals which is required or which is essential for the plant. If suppose like in that, there is a Fe, cobalt, nickel, phosphorus. These all ions are very much important for the better growth and development of plant health also. Now it is very difficult, but sometimes it is very difficult to absorb these metal ions directly present in soil, but due to hydrated form of these submetals, the plant cannot take these nutrients directly. Now if this hydrated form of Fe is present in soil, but plant cannot take this Fe from that type of or that from that form of the complex here. So that's why if we treating this with the EDTA, then it form a soluble EDTA complex, that is Fe-EDTA complex. So here it can easily absorb by the plant for the better result and for the better growth and nourishment of the plant health also. So these are the various applications of coordination compound. In summary, we are going to discuss the overlook of our chapter. To summarize this chapter, we discuss the main points or the following important topics in this chapter. In that chapter, we discuss the basic terms related to coordination compound. In that, we discuss what is meant by the ligand, what is meant by metal, center metal atom, coordination sphere, coordination compound, charge on the metal, coordination number. Along with that, also we discuss the types of ligand, what is the difference between the metal chelate and metal complex, what is meant by the metal chelate and metal complex. Now, also we discuss the coordination compound and double salts. Along with that, we also discuss the difference between the double salts and coordination compound. In that, also we are discuss the Werner works and theory. In that, we discuss what is meant by the primary valency and secondary valency. What are the basic differences between the primary valency and secondary valency? How to calculate the oxidation state of center metal atom? EN rule, that is effective atomic number rule. Then also we discuss the IUPAC nomenclature of the coordination compounds, and the last point, that is application of coordination compounds in various fields. So these are the all summary of our top chapter. Now we will stop here. In next lecture, we are going to start with the new topic, that is molecular orbital theory of covalent bonding. Thank you.